traders, Privateer FX coming at you with the preview for the New York Open. We got what we wanted in Europe. Euro lower, core short paid. Now we're sitting here at the lows, and I guess we expect New York, as they normally will do, will take it a little bit lower, and then we kind of have to wait for these auctions. These bond auctions that everyone's waiting for to see how that goes for our next decision on what to do. But we've taken our shorts back here. We will resell back between 70 and 90, and we will fade the New York move down to sort of, we expect them to take it down maybe to 20 or so. But we're square euro now, moving on to the next trade. We got an interesting print in our little Euro Aussie configuration here. This looks like an interesting level now. Very interesting one. 56.07. Two lows there. All these tops here. What's going to drive Euro Aussie? It's not super clear. Maybe a big Euro flush. Maybe some Aussie movement higher. We have Aussie wage data out tonight, so that could be the trigger. Definitely a level to keep an eye on, 156.07 in Euro Aussie. Cable had a funny little day. Lower through the open down to 30, and then some positive Brexit news. All of a sudden Europe is like, well, maybe we'll give them a special deal. Cable went all the way back up to 15, now we're back at 80. Not really sure what to do with this. Although, if we continue to get positive news out of Europe, maybe they're thinking now that Brexit is going to be good for them. They get much more financial business, and trade will surely remain the same for them at a minimum. I don't know, but if we continue to get positive news, Euro Sterling's our vehicle. Through the 200 unit 4-hourly moving average, 88.33. This should now provide resistance today. We're 28.9. For those of you who are positive on Brexit going forward, which we're still on the fence here, Euro Sterling is your vehicle. If you look at this now on the dailies, close to bearish engulfing, even though mid-range. This could easily get down to 86.90 later in the week, especially if Euro continues to go lower. U.S. rates are higher, 290.5. This is fully dependent on the auctions later today, so we're going to keep a very close eye. 4:30 Central European time for the auctions. We'll have to see how that goes. We've got, I think, 90 yards of bills coming out, and this is going to be very closely watched, and I think now this is going to be a very interesting macro idea, whether there are less buyers of U.S. debt based on the deficits, increasing deficits. Let's take a look across yen here. If we get a big risk-off move today, this looks okay. Down here, 131.60. Been a while since we've come close to this moving average, which is now 131 the figure. If we cross through 60, we surely will probably test this moving average, and if we break it, there's a long way to go down in Euro Yen. So we'll be watching this level very, very closely, 131.60. Aussie, we slipped down through 90, down to 82, but no real love there. We're just watching this for ideas on our Euro Aussie level. Again, we have wage inflation, we have wage data out in Australia tonight. This should be a mover and could be our trigger for Euro Aussie. Cryptos, just generally higher. Not much to do here, but hold your core longs. A lot of people now disappointed they did not buy the dip. They should start chasing this, especially Ethereum, back through 1,000. You'll see some guys chasing longs if we print up through 1,000. Other than that, we have dollar yen, which broke through 107, printed a high of 107.20. It's a tug of war in dollar yen. We have higher rates, but then we have a little bit of a risk-off sentiment today with S&P's now trading down. It's 27.12 at the moment. This is a delayed chart. Equities don't look that great, gotta say. With the bear market still intact, we could see more of a flush lower, especially if there's weak demand for U.S. paper later today. So we're watching this very closely. We have our structures on downside, but we don't have minis on at the moment. We're going to be looking for maybe a possible print at 2700. Maybe a pivot will be created there. And we will be looking to short minis if we get the right technical setup. Our dear friend Dollar Rand turning higher now after these exaggerated lows. We'll be looking for a pivot at 1180. We got this budget out of South Africa tomorrow. There's really no way this can be positive. The numbers are a disaster. They're about to be downgraded by Moody's. Political change is nice, but I don't know. We're very skeptical of this move in dollar rand, as you all know, and we're looking for clever ways to get long dollar rand for a trip back up to 13. So I guess in general, we are sellers of euros on the rally. Like we said, we're going to fade this first move down once Europe gets in, but core short is the way. So we're not going to be getting long to hold longs. We're just going to be trading around longs and waiting for the bond auctions in the U.S. for our next trigger and signal. Best chart out there is Euro Aussie, 156.07. Keep an eye on it. All right, short and sweet today. Good luck out there. Talk to you tomorrow. Ciao.